Hello, it's Jeanette with GeoMazing Paper Crafts. Thank you for joining me today. I'm back with another video tutorial. Today's tutorial is something that's very, very easy to do, and I just want to show you that I'm going to be sending these out to the customers that placed orders with me in January, and it's just the cutest little book. I'll untie this here. It's like a little composition book, but it could also be a little journal book for anyone, you know, who likes to take notes. It's just so cute and so small. And so what I've really done, actually, is just covered one of these little mini composition books that I got at the Dollar Tree store. You get them like $3-$4. But they have 50 pages. I mean, they come with a lot of pages so for you to write notes in. And I thought, let me cover it with some of our new designer series paper, the one that came from the Celebrations catalog, and that is called Carried Away. It's right here. Okay, and this coincides with the bundle called Lift Me Up, I believe, and it's got the hot air balloons. It's so pretty. It's Lift Me Up bundle, and it's got a coordinating dies called Up and Away Thinlit Dies. Okay, it's such a cute set. I absolutely love the hot air balloons and everything that you can do with it. But this paper here you can get for free with a qualifying purchase. In the United States, it's if you order $50 in Stampin' Up! Products in my store, we can send you this paper or any one of these products from the Celebrations catalogs. But you only have till March 31st, so let's get going on that, okay? So anyway, I want to thank all my customers that came shopping with me in January, and this is the gift that I'm going to be sending you out. But I also want to show you how easy it is to cover one of these books, and we'll do that right now, okay? Now we're going to be using a piece of designer series paper from the Carried Away stack, and this measures 8 inches by 6 inches, and you're also going to need two little pieces for the inside. That's this inside cover here, okay? And that is, these two pieces measure 3 inches by 4 inches, okay? So you need two of them. And you also could use a scrap of Whisper White, and that's so that you can stamp and die cut these two little items. That's what I'm going to do and show you how to do that. So let's get going with this designer series paper, and I'm going to bring in my Simply Scored scoring tool. Okay, and on the 8-inch side, I'm going to score this at 3 7/8. Okay, and then I'm also going to score this at 4 1/8. Okay, and what that's going to do is that is going to give you the right amount of space for the spline right here, okay? And now I'm gonna turn this, and I'm gonna score this at 3/4 inch. Okay, and then I'm also gonna turn it around 180 degrees and score it again at 3/4 inch. Or you can do, let's see, what would that mark be? I guess it would be 5 1/4 if you didn't wanna turn your paper. So it's 3/4 inch and 5 1/4, or 3/4 inch, turn it 3/4 inch, okay? So, now the reason I'm not going to score lines on this side is because I'm not going to, when I fold it, that's when I'll know exactly what the score line is. So I'm not gonna do that because I don't wanna set it there and then the score line be a little bit different. I'll be folding, and that's how I make my score line. So I'll show you what I mean. Let me take this scoreboard away. And I'm gonna go ahead and just fold the two inside score lines, okay? All right. Sorry about that. That's from my nail polish. I'm impatient about letting my nail polish dry, so it scrapes off the top. Okay. So now I have these two score lines down the middle, and I can see the score lines on the top and the bottom. I don't know if you can or not, but what I need to do is take my paper snips, and I'm just going to go ahead and wedge in a little bit up to that score line, actually going a little beyond that score line, and I'm going to just cut this off here, okay? And I'm actually cutting the score line off. Okay, and I'm going to do the same for this side. Just wedging in a little bit, going a little beyond that score line, wedging it on this side, and then just completely cutting that score line off right there. Okay, and that's going to give me enough room on this side to fit my book like that. I got to be careful that I'm actually putting it in right side up with my balloons make sense, because these little pages actually have a header to them. Okay, so let's get some tear and tape on here so that we can stick our book. And I'm just going to try my best. Actually, let me bring in my silicone craft sheet, because I always, always get this tear and tape on my grid sheet, and I don't want to do that. So I'm just putting it straight down the middle. All right, and I'm going to cut it. I don't want to tear it, because sometimes I actually tear the paper when I do that. But I cut it. So let me bring in my paper piercing tool to pick up that protective coating paper. Okay, and then I am going to bring in my, make sure I've got it right. I'm going to bring in my little composition book, and I'm going to try to center that. I'm going to do one side here with the tape and just try to make sure that that is right centered down the middle. Okay. And then I'll just go ahead and burnish that tape in. And so now I've got my folded here. Okay, so now that I have my my book adhered down the spleen here, I'm going to be needing to fold these sides and the all around, and that's where my true score line will be. So with the book closed, I'm going to fold it like this. Okay. Now I don't want to do it while the book is open, because then it's going to bulge if you do that. So I like to do it while the book is closed. We're going to get the, make sure you've got the cardboard and not the papers, just the cardboard. The book is closed. You're going to get that score line going by folding. Okay, and so now there shouldn't be any bulge when it closed, but you're still going to need a little bit of help closing this, and that's why I use the string. Okay, so let's do the top parts, to the top and bottoms. I'm going to go ahead and fold those score lines. All right, let me use my bone folder because I want to crease it really nice here, and the bottom part too. Now, I'm not going to be adhering these to the back of the book. I'm not going to do that. And that's because I want the book to be able to do a little bit of sliding inside here. So basically, I'm going to be creating a little casing. So once I've got these top and sides folded, I'm going to be... sure that that's right here. I'm going to be making another diagonal cut. Okay. Let's see. Okay. Now the diagonal cut that I need to make, let me put that away for a second here, is from here to here, but I want to leave some of that score line because I don't want any of the opposite side of the paper showing on the corners. So I'm cutting here and here, okay, on both sides. Now, just got to look and make sure I know. I don't know that you can see that score line. Okay, it's right there. And we're going to cut right here. So there's like a little triangle of, here. When you do yours, you're going to see what I'm talking about, because I did not cut, I can cut that a little bit more. I didn't cut that score line off, and I don't want to do that. So before I go any further, I'm not going to be taping this, but what I need to do, is I need to put some tear and tape down the middle. Or actually, you know what? I think I'm going to go ahead and use my fast fuse. I'm going to put some fast fuse down the middle here. Okay, let me get it started here. Okay. Just to the edge. And then I'm going to take a piece of string, and this is actual baker's twine, and I'm going to take a piece about maybe 18 inches and cut it in half to make it around 9 inches. You might not need that much, but I thought 18 inches was perfect in cutting it in half. I still end up trimming just a little bit. Now I'm going to take that string, and I'm going to go ahead and place it where I put that where I put the fast fuse, all the way down here. Okay. Now I'm going to take the cover, making sure that this is the right side up. Okay. Yep, that's the right side up. And I'm going to go ahead and take some fast fuse, and just along the edges, on three sides. Did I do the wrong side? I'm going to have to save this for the other side. Let me make sure I'm doing this right. So the balloons go this way. So I need to put tape on this side, and that side. Okay. Let me put this aside so I don't get this all stuck. So this side, and that side. Okay. And I'm just putting it just on the edge, okay, because I don't want this to stick to the cardboard. I just want it to stick to this paper that I wrapped. Okay, let's stick this down. All right, I'm going to try my best to make sure that it is, there it is, right here. Okay. And so now the closing and opening this book is not going to be difficult, because this is this cardboard cover is kind of freely in there, like it's encased in there but not glued in there. Okay, so that's kind of important, because otherwise this is going to bulge. So let's do this side here. We're going to put the tape. I'm going to put these two flaps down so I know where to stop the tape for my string, right down the middle, best you can down the middle. Bring in your string. Okay. Hold that string down. And now I've already put the tape on here. Let me make sure I've got this. Yep, I got it going right. I've already put the fast fuse on the edges, so I'm just going to go ahead and place this right here and here. And now I've got the two strings attached. It's actually folded kind of quite nicely. And then you just make yourself a little bow here. And now you've got your little book. Now let's decorate the top. So what I have is that stamp set, which is called Lift Me Up. Okay, Lift Me Up. And I'm going to be using this little balloon right here to decorate the front. So let's get some Whisper White cardstock. And I am going to bring down my Knight of Navy, because that's the color that I want to use, Knight of Navy. And I'm going to just go ahead and stamp that. Okay. Very nice. And then I'm also going to stamp the sentiment, which says thank you, because I am very thankful for my customers. And there we go. All right, let's close it. Now we're going to take our dies. Oh, I had them out here. Okay. And the die is coordinates with the set. And I'm going to go ahead and put this right here with a little bit of repositionable adhesive, because I don't want this to jump around on my magnetic platform. And I'm going to also put this little die to cut out that little thank you. Isn't that the cutest little square die? Or actually, it's a rectangle, not a square. I just love this little tiny tag of thank you. I'm just going to go ahead and take this to the big shot, and I will be right back. Okay, here we are. Let's take this tape off. So we got this tag, and we got our little hot air balloon. And let's put these dies away. Oop, not drop them. Okay. And now I'm going to adhering them with some Stampin' Dimensionals. Let me turn this one around. I'm going to put about three of them on here, on the back. Okay, and then I'm going to cut one to put just along that little basket. Okay. And let's take this off here. Now, I thought about using the, what are these called? The foam adhesive strips, but I noticed that they're quite a bit thicker than the Stampin' Dimensionals. So if you're thinking about combining both, you know, both of these adhesives, just be aware that the foam adhesive is a little bit thicker than the other ones. Now I wanted to do it on a little bit of a slant, and now I'm going to take one of the dimensionals and just cut it in half and use it on this side here. Putting one on that side and one on this side. Okay, and let me put my thank you right here, kind of toward the center. Okay, and now we're all done. Isn't that cute? Make a cute little book for someone, even a child, if you have little children that you want to have them take notes or make notes. You can use it as an address book too, just about anything. I have one of these sitting on my desk, and any new addresses that don't fit in my old address book get put in one of these little books. So I thought it would make a cute little... I don't make a bow. Not on camera. Not right now. Okay. So anyway, I hope that you enjoyed watching this. I hope that I taught you a little something. Because, you know, I like to share with you. And I hope that you'll try this. And if you need any of the tools and the supplies that I used in this video, you know where to go. www.geoamazingpapercrafts.stampinup.net. I'd be happy to be your demonstrator if you don't already have one, or you can join my team and save when you purchase Stampin' Up! Products. So once again, I'm Jeanette with Geoamazing Papercrafts, and you make it a great day. Bye-bye.